This video and the next are about how we use calculus to describe continuous random variables. So a random variable is some quantity that you don't know. You know, it's something that depends on chance, like the temperature tomorrow, or the score of next week's football game, or what the Dow Jones average is going to be 3 months from now, or where a dart that I throw at the board lands. There are lots and lots of things in the real world that depend on chance. Now, for some of them, there is a list of possible values, and you just say, what's the probability of this value? What's the probability of that value? What's the chance of getting heads? What's the chance of getting tails? But for a continuous random variable means that there's a whole continuous range of possible outcomes. So you don't describe the probability of any one point. You describe the probability of little intervals. In other words, you have to talk about a probability density function. And it's usually abbreviated a PDF, and it's usually written with a lowercase f, little f of x. There's a different function that's written with a capital F. We're not going to talk about that today. Okay, so for example, if the probability density function is given by a curve like this, and you want to know what is the likelihood of getting some number between A and B, you integrate the density function from A to B, and you say, hey, let's take this region, and of course, the integral from A to B is the same thing as the area under the curve. And so the likelihood of landing in this range is given by the area of the shaded region. And so that's how we use PDFs, or density functions, to describe probabilities. Now, the density functions have to satisfy a couple of rules. The first is, there's no such thing as negative probability, so the density always has to be at least zero. And the second is that the total probability, the probability of landing somewhere, what's the probability of being somewhere between negative infinity and infinity? Well, 100%. So that's given by, so the integral from negative infinity to infinity of our density has to equal 1. So you're often given problems where you're told the form of the function. It's a constant times such and such function, and you have to figure out the constant. And the way you figure out the constant is you compute the integral, you set it equal to 1, and then you evaluate the constant. Okay? Key thing to remember is that f of x is not a probability. It's a probability density. If x is measured in feet, then this is in the units of f is inverse feet. Chance per unit foot. Okay, so there are a bunch of standard distributions that come up all the time in probability. The simplest one is called the unform distribution. And when somebody says, pick a number randomly between 0 and 1, they're usually talking about the unform distribution. So the density is just dead flat. The probability of landing between 0 and a half is a half. The probability of landing between 1/3 and 2/3 is 1/3. The probability of landing in any given region here is just the area of that region, which is just delta x times 1. And of course, the average value is a half. We'll talk more about average values later on. Now, you also talk about the unform distribution on an interval from A to B. So it's a certain constant here. And what is that constant? Well, the total area under the curve has to be 1. And since the width is B minus A, the height must be 1 over B minus A. So that describes the unform distribution on an interval. So if something is distributed uniformly between 3 and 5, then it has probability density a half between 3 and 5. Another example that comes up a lot is called the exponential distribution. Now, the standard exponential distribution is just given by a density function e to the minus x, and you can check that the integral from 0 to infinity of e to the minus x is 1. And we will calculate in the next video that the average value is in fact 1. This is often used to describe lifetimes of electronic appliances and other things that just have a certain chance per unit, per day of failing. but they don't wear out over time. They might fail today, and if they don't fail today, well, they might fail tomorrow, and if they don't fail tomorrow, they might fail the next day. So the lifetime of a light bulb or of a piece of stereo equipment is probably given by the exponential distribution. And you can talk about an exponential distribution not with average 1. It usually you describe the average by a number called lambda, and it's just the same thing stretched out. And if it's stretched out, remember the area has to be 1, so it has to also be shrunk. So it's 1 over lambda times e to the minus x over lambda. And then the average value is lambda. And then the most famous continuous distribution is the standard bell-shaped curve. Whenever you have something that comes about by the accumulation of lots and lots and lots and lots of small independent influences, you usually wind up with this bell-shaped curve, and it's described by the function e to the minus x squared over 2 times the normalization. Now, you remember from polar coordinates that we computed the integral of e to the minus x squared from minus infinity to infinity. E to the minus x squared over 2, you wind up with root 2 pi instead of root pi, but this is something that we got from polar coordinates. That's the normal distribution, and you can scale it. You can move it over a distance mu, so its average is mu, and you can stretch it out by a factor sigma, so its width is sigma, and then this is the ugly formula for that. So those are the continuous distributions that come up most often in real life. In the next video, we'll talk about the average values and the widths of those distributions.